This video is about the principle of moments. A moment is a turning effect about a pivot, created by applying a force to a lever. Here, the spanner is the lever and the nut the pivot. A force is applied to the handle. A moment is calculated using the equation moment equals force times perpendicular distance from the pivot. The perpendicular distance is the distance at right angles to the direction of the force applied. The units for moments are Newton meters or Newton centimeters. This comes from the units of newtons for force and the units of meters or centimeters for distance. This diagram shows another common type of lever, a beam balancing on a pivot. The principle of moments states that if an object is balanced, the total clockwise moment about a pivot equals the total anti-clockwise moment about that pivot. This means that the moments acting in the clockwise direction are equal to the forces or moments acting in the anti-clockwise direction. Consider the moments acting in the clockwise direction. These are equal to the moments acting in the anti-clockwise direction. In the diagram, force 2 times distance 2 is equal to force 1 times distance 1 plus force 3 times distance 3. This worked example is about James using a spanner to loosen a nut. James is applying a force of 200 newtons on a spanner to loosen a nut from his table. The dimensions of the spanner are shown in the diagram. Part A states the direction of rotation applied by the 200 newton force for 1 mark. Look at the diagram carefully and imagine a clock face. Drawing an arrow continuing the motion of the spanner shows that this is a clockwise rotation for 1 mark. Extending the force arrows is the key to understanding what is happening, especially in more complex moment questions. Part B is to calculate the moment of the 200 newton force about the nut for 3 marks. You must first identify the pivot. In this question, this is the nut. The lever, the part of the system the force is being applied to. In this question, this is the spanner. The load in this question is the 200 newton force from James moving the spanner clockwise. Recall the equation for calculating a moment. 1 mark. Substitute the quantities. Find the perpendicular distance to the load. Continue the force arrow until it joins with the distance at right angles. The question says the answer must be written in Newton meters. Hence, the distance perpendicular to the load is 20 centimeters, which is 0.2 meters. A moment is equal to 200 times 0.2 for the second mark. Now calculate the moment. Moment is equal to 40 Newton meters for the final mark. Always show you're working for each step. Part C is to explain why James cannot move the nut using his hands, but it begins to turn when he uses the spanner for 3 marks. We know that moment equals force times distance for the first mark. The question says it is easier for James to turn the nut using a spanner instead of his hands. This implies that the spanner provides a larger moment for the second mark. James is providing a constant force, so he can get a larger moment from turning at a greater distance from the pivot, which is what the spanner provides, for the third mark. Increasing the length of the lever from the pivot will reduce the force needed to move an object. All these examples show that by having a longer lever, a smaller force is needed to carry the load. Part D. The spanner and nut get stuck again and no longer rotate. Use the principle of moments to explain why for 2 marks. State the principle of moments for 1 mark. This means that the moment of the 200 newton force applied clockwise by James is equal to the moment of the frictional force between the screw and the table for the second mark. No other forces are described on the diagram, so you need to consider what force is providing the anti-clockwise moment. The nut is fastened into a table, so it must be the friction that provides the anti-clockwise moment on the pivot, preventing the clockwise moment, which James needs to move it. In summary, a moment is defined by a turning effect on a pivot. Moments can have a clockwise or an anti-clockwise direction. The direction used to calculate a moment is moment is equal to force times perpendicular distance. A moment can be increased by increasing the magnitude of the force and increasing the length. The principle of moment states that if an object is balanced, the total clockwise moment about a pivot equals the total anti-clockwise moment about that pivot. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.